And Nietzsche, which even though he's not a believer and he's a nihilist, but he's correct in realizing that to live to suffer. Now, one of the Four Noble Truths in Buddhism is what? Life is suffering, right? It's the First Noble Truth. And Nietzsche said to live to suffer. And in order to survive suffering, you have to find some meaning in suffering. Okay? So he had this profound truth that if you want to survive in this world, you will survive the horror of terror. You survive the emptiness, the pain of meaninglessness. The antidote is finding meaning for your suffering. Okay? And now, come with Frankl now. So with Frankl, struggle with problem suffering more than most people. You know, his family was wiped out by Nazi concentration camp. He himself suffered intensely in four different camps, and he survived. And he witnessed, you know, the devastation of Second World War and the collapse of values. So he wrote a story about his life, A Man's Search for Meaning. How many people have read this book? Oh, quite a number. So if you have a chance, trying to get a whole copy, it doesn't cost that much. It's about $8 when you pay back. So he was struggling, Jack Buddha, struggling to find what is the meaning of human suffering? And how can we rise above that? That's a basic question. Buddha struggled with that, and Frankl struggled with that, and Nietzsche struggled with that, Solomon struggled with that. And how can we find meaning that enable us to transcend human suffering and death? So I just summarized his contributions, but he's remembered primarily as the first psychotherapist to pull the human soul back to human beings. Okay? Freud talked about animal instincts, okay? And Adler talked about the will to power, about ranking, who is on top, who is the alpha male, who he control. But Frankl said, no, human beings are basically spiritual beings, and the deepest longing is the will, is the desire to find meaning. Now, he's not put the meaning where it belongs. The search for meaning originates in what? In the fact that we are spiritual beings. So spirituality is the source of the search for meaning, okay? And the major task of psychotherapy is spiritual care. That's interesting, huh? And nurses talk about spiritual care. The clinical nursing really focus on spiritual care, right? And all the doctors and social workers working in hospice talk about spiritual care. Spiritual care is also the domain of psychotherapy. If you really, really want to resolve many psychological problems, especially problem of meaning, you have to deal with the fact that we are spiritual beings. That you have to know how to provide spiritual care in order to find some relief for human suffering.